Welcome to ACC Student News.
The news students can use. I'm Aziza.
And I'm Dominic. Here are this week's stories. The city of Gary is only a couple months away from having no money to operate the city government. Mayoral Chief of Staff Dana Bennett told members of the city's council that the only solution to balance the city's budget is selling and leasing back the public safety building. She believes that the sale and lease back will give the city time to implement and financial recovery plan. This plan is to include a combination of restructuring city departments, payroll reductions, revenue enhancements, and state legislative changes. Gary adopted a $54 million budget for this year, but is only expected that they will collect about $30 million in property taxes.
Police are investigating the disappearance of $326,000 in public money at Independence Hills Conservancy District in Maryville. Independent Hills Conservancy District is a special property tasing agency that collects sewage from about 2,500 homes in the southwest corner of Maryville. According to the Times, the money was found missing earlier this week following a routine check of the agency's accounts. The chairman of the board of directors of the sewage collection agency said they found a series of unapproved withdrawals that had taken place in an improvement fund where money is kept to pay for construction projects. A reporter from the Indiana State Board of Accounts indicated that there was about $2 million in the improvement account.
Bishop Knoll plans to announce the plans for a $1 million state-of-the-art STREAM Lab. The STREAM Lab will allow for students to prepare for careers in science, technology, engineering, performing arts, and math, with faith and religion at the heart of it all. The School City of Hammond School Board gave their approval in August for their project to be funded primarily through the school's Ignite and Inspire capital campaign that is aimed at shoring up donations for renovations and new programs. According to the principal, Paul Molani, the lab will be the centerpiece of the school's drive to become the first elite STREAM school in Indiana. STREAM is the school's version of STEM, which only includes science, technology, engineering, and math.
The Miss America pageant took out the swimsuit competition for the first time in 98 years, leaving viewers not watching. According to Nielsen, 4.34 million people watched the pageant on Sunday, which is down by 19% from last year's viewers. Former Fox News personality Gretchen Carlson took over leadership of the pageant, and she removed the controversial swimsuit competition, replacing it with on-stage interviews where contestants talked about President Trump, the NFL, player protests, and other topics. At the beginning of the ceremony, a comedian who warmed up the crowd mentioned there would be no swimsuit competition, and audience booed. Newly crowned Miss America Nia Franklin stated that she was more than happy that she wasn't a swimsuit competition, and she was about to win it with more than her looks.
Students at Indiana University Northwest will once again have the chance to engage in an unusual but educational experience. IUN School of Medicine is bringing back the International Cadaver Dissection Program. Next summer, students will have hands-on experience with the cadavers. This experience will allow students not to only learn real-life human anatomy, but they will also get insight into medical imaging, wounds, suturing.
Former San Francisco 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick has unveiled a controversial ad of a Nike ad. The campaign for Nike is believe in something, even if it means sacrificing everything. The endorsement deal sparked a vigorous debate, with some fans expressing displeasure over the apparel. Giant support for an NFL player who set off a flurry among NFL players against police brutality, racial inequality. Some angry fans were even burning and cutting out the signature swoosh logos on their gear and posting results on social media. Kaepernick and his Nike campaign, which marks the 30th anniversary of Nike's Just Do It, received plenty of support from the sports and fashion worlds Tuesday.
That's all we have for this week. I'm Dominic.
I'm Luca Lopez.
I'm Aziza.
Make sure to watch the rest of our videos on YouTube.
And follow us on Twitter.
at ACC TV Hammond.